Greetings, friends of typography. Font menus are getting longer and longer, even if you just use the system fonts that come with today's operating systems. A professional font management application is a good solution to categorize, browse, and activate your fonts, but those apps don't come cheap, and so they aren't for everyone. In this video, we are looking at ways to print a customizable catalog of some or all of your fonts without having to spend anything. We first look at an app that is available for Windows, macOS, and Linux, and then I have some additional recommendations for macOS users and Adobe InDesign users. So let's get started. So the app we are looking at now is called Print My Fonts. The link to the app is in the description of this video, and you can send the author of the app, Stefan Trost, a donation if you like. This is how the app looks, and now let's check out our options. We have the choice to print all installed fonts, but we can also choose folders, which can be useful if you use your file system to order fonts or if, for example, you want to print the list of fonts belonging to a certain project. You can also filter by name, style, and so on. Of course, we can customize the font sample text. You can show the font name as a font sample, a sentence, or an entire alphabet. You can also modify these entries and create your own. You can put in any Unicode character, so if necessary, you can print entire character sets this way. Then there is a description line with additional information like family name, style, file system location, and font format. And we can choose how to export the catalog as images, Word document, local website, or we can just print it to a connected printer or as a PDF. And that's how simple it is to create a font catalog with this app. If you are using macOS, you are probably aware that you already have a font management app that comes with the operating system called Fontbook. But you might not be aware that it has sophisticated options to print font samples of individual or multiple fonts, and you can also easily create a catalog of all your fonts. To access these options, select one, multiple, or all fonts, and then access the print option from the file menu or press Command P. You can choose between a waterfall view as shown here, a character set view where you can define the glyph size, and there is a catalog view to show a basic alphabet of each font. And again, we can send that to a printer or open it as a PDF. And finally, we take a look at an option to print font character sets in Adobe InDesign. Typically, when text is saved, copied, and shared among different apps, the glyphs are accessed by their Unicode value. But in an OpenType font, there can be glyphs which don't have a Unicode value because they are only meant to be accessed by OpenType features. And this can limit our options to view or print the entire glyph set of a font. But Adobe InDesign is able to access every glyph in a font by its glyph ID. So basically the order in which the glyphs are stored in a font file. And we can use that to create a complete glyph overview of a font. In the description of this video, I put a link to a script to do that. And it is called Font Table. You can put the script in the script folder of the InDesign application and then access it from the script panel. We first have to choose a font, and then we have to set an upper limit for the glyph IDs. you can just put a high number in here, or alternatively, you open the Glyphs panel first, select the font, make sure the ordering is set to Glyph ID, and then we can scroll to the end to see the highest ID used in the specific font. And now we can just use that value to create our complete Glyph overview. And there you have it. And that's it for this episode. If you liked this video, make sure to subscribe and to hit the bell icon to get notified when new episodes are released. You can also support the creation of future episodes like this one by becoming a patron, which also gives you access to exclusive articles, videos, and downloads.